I'm going to present CTO of Anomalous RCA and his anti-grade approach. So before that, going to the history. So 35 years old male patient comes with complaints of chest pain and exertion since 3 months. He's a chronic smoker and ethanolic. And there is no history of any hypertension or diabetes. And there is no family history significant. On examination, pulse rate was 75 beats per minute regular. Blood pressure was 130/80. And EKG showed QS in inferior leads. And 2D echo showed is a regional wall motion in inferior RCA territory. And it could be old inferior wall MI. Lab test was normal. So we went for angiogram. So CSG done through right radial artery route, and it showed left system was absolutely normal. And through left injections, we saw the retrograde filling of RCA till mid RCA. And the RCA anomalous origin. So we tried for RCA and the right coronary sinus. So we could not get it. Then we spent some time, and then we thought it is from the left sinus. Then it was from left sinus and it showed mid total occlusion. You can see here, this is a left coronary angiogram. The circumflex is normal, LAD is normal. You can see here the RCA filling from the left side faintly. You can see here retrograde filling of the RCA, aryocaudal view. This is the epicranial view. Here you can see better. Whole big RCA is filling from the left coronary injection. So this is the RCA. So the blunt end was there, and at the stump there was a branch, the RVO view. We used Judkin cath for this. So normal JR we could not. So now we don't do normally retrograde technique or CTO techniques. So, and this is a scheme case, so it's not affordable. So we wanted to do anti-grade technique only. So what best available in our cath lab? So our strategy was, so we should go femoral approach, and we discussed with our colleagues. So we thought XB catheter or AL2 or JL3.5, and guide wires we have BMW, Kogar XT, Pilot and Fielder FC. So we went through femoral approach, and first, this is the successful second attempt actually. First attempt we did, and we tried for 2-3 hours. And because of contrast volume overload, so we have stopped it. And again, after 2 days, again we have taken it. So first attempt, we have tried with AL2, and catheter was engaged, and we could hardly cross the lesion. And once we crossed the lesion, but balloon was not going. So then time was over, and volume overload, so we have taken back. And next day, after 2 days, again we have taken. So this time we took JL3.5 guide catheter, and our luck is we saw some faint filling. So this might be due to the first attempt, this thing, the cap has been ruptured and it went in. This Fielder FC wire, but still we could not negotiate the balloons. So first we have taken the buddy wire technique, normal Kogar XT wire we have taken and kept into the branch. Then that catheter given some stability. So first graded ballooning we did, 1.25 into 8 centimeters balloon, then 2 into 15 centimeters balloon. This is 2 into 15 millimeters, sapphire balloon. Then we have taken 3.5 into 32 mm drug-eluting strain. Then it was fine, everything went on well. After this, post-dilated with 3.5 into 8 mm of NC sapphire balloon. And this was the final results. My take-home message is JL 3.5 guide catheter was helped a lot in this patient. And femoral approach should be taken when there is anomalous RCA, this thing. And hardware should be there in your cath lab, guide catheters, other guide wires, CTO guide wire should be there. And you have to have patience to stand long in the cath lab. And also, if you're not successful, again, if you try, you may successful. Thank you for